And now we're going to make some happy little trees. Just back and forth, back and forth. You know, let's go crazy.
What's up, everybody? Victor here again. And today, we'll be doing the first of, hopefully many, one-day build projects. We will be transforming this Shrek-tastic Nerf gun into a realistic movie prop inspired by Halo Reach. For under 20 bucks and a day of work, you too can transform a boring plastic toy into an awesome science fiction prop. Subscribe to my channel for more creative projects, and you can always change your mind later on. Now, without further ado, let's get started. The first step is optional, but in my opinion, it helps with the final results. Using a combination of hobby blades and sandpaper, I removed the plastic Nerf lettering and branding. Once I finished removing the branding, it was time to remove the screws. Using a regular Phillips head screwdriver and the power of editing, I remove all the screws and take out the batteries. I want to be thorough with my paint job, so it's important to me that none of the original colors peek through. Here's what the inside looks like. I mask off some of the electronic components and bring it outside. You're going to need a face mask, a spray can primer, in this case, I'm using this automotive one, and some gloves. When spray painting, it's important to use multiple light coats of paint. I usually use 3 to 4 coats to slowly build up the color. You don't want to rush the paint, so just take your time and take breaks in between the layers. I also used this leftover automotive paint I had laying around, and it helped give me a dark silver metallic look. Once it's all dry, I take it back inside for acrylic paints. You'll notice some remaining orange parts from the original toy, and that's on purpose. These are moving parts, so I don't want to interfere with them by adding paint, so I left them alone. Using black acrylic paint, I add it to areas where I think it would be darkest. After painting the dark areas, I reassemble the blaster, paying extra attention to make sure that each part goes to their right spots. But the question is, does this still work? Let's find out. Cool. I remove the batteries again, put back some more screws, and continue painting. Here I did a lot of dry brushing. Using a chip brush, I add only the smallest amount of paint. It's a really simple technique, but the results are amazing. Lightly brush away at the edges to give the impression of wear and tear. This is all up to you, so go crazy or keep it really simple. Using more masking tape, I section off a portion of the rifle. I dab on some yellow paint and remove the tape once dry. To finish it off, lightly wipe away the paint using sandpaper. This will help tie the entire look together. I put the batteries back in one last time and finished off the build by adding a spray clear coat to help protect my work. Like the spray paint, I also use multiple thin coats. And here's what the final results look like. Repaints are super fun and are a great way for you to enhance the looks of any toy. I appreciate you watching. And hit that bell icon so you'll be notified the next time I post a new video. So until next time, take care.
Inconceivable!